Hey guys, it's Putty for Rustified here with a quick summary of what's coming into Rust this month. A large change to the Rust landscape goes live with this update. The new work cart and tunnel system that has been under development for quite some time has finally been added. This update doesn't just entail a new mode of transportation and some tunnels. It includes an entirely new procedurally generated underground ecosystem with NPCs and loot. To access this new underground world, there are various entry points around the map. In total, there are about 20 stations on a default map size. They are placed near roads and most monuments. After entering a station, you can walk down a couple flights of stairs to reach the elevator. Simply call the elevator using the button. You can also take the stairs if you wish, but I do caution you it will take a while because you have to walk down 25 levels. Once down, you are almost to the tunnel system. You just have to traverse a small series of corridors and another elevator or stairs. Just follow the signs and you'll get there. The tunnels link up to the majority of the map and feature various loot boxes, work carts, and NPCs. You can also see the layout of the tunnels on your map. But before you start exploring, make sure you have the right equipment, as the tunnel system is full of hostile tunnel dwellers. NPC tunnel dwellers have a jumpsuit and a gas mask. They have 125 HP and are armed with either a pistol or a rifle. Like other NPCs, they don't drop actual gear they are holding. Instead, you'll find a mixture of lower tier loot, such as components, ammo, and meds. Speaking of loot, there's also traditional loot boxes that can be found when exploring the tunnels. They spawn mostly around platforms near tunnel dweller locations. Now onto the most exciting part, the new work carts. These spawn near tunnel platforms. To get one moving, you simply have to add fuel to the storage container behind the driver's cabin and mount the driver's seat. Driving is very straightforward. There's a throttle with three speeds in both forward and reverse. Simply tap W to throttle up and S to throttle down, or go in reverse. When it comes to a fork in the tracks, you can either hold down A or D to go left or right as you travel over the junction. All your speed and fuel information is tracked on the digital dashboard display directly in front of you. Now, you can dismount from the driver's seat and the cart will continue to move at the same speed. But there won't be any runaways as the cart will slowly come to a stop if you jump off or nobody is physically on the cart. Carts have 1000 HP and are pretty durable, but if you run into a couple destructible barricades or other carts, damage can add up quickly. Luckily, you can repair them with a hammer and some metal frags. Overall, I'm excited to see how this new system will change how we play Rust. A new way to scratch that Rust gambling itch has made its way in this month. Slot machines have been added to the Bandit Camp. Found in the same room as the roulette wheel, these three machines operate on scrap and offer some considerable payouts. The cost per spin is 2 scrap. There's been some tweaks to drone delivery fees this month. The delivery fee now is per each purchase. This means each time you click buy, you'll be charged 1 delivery fee. Some smaller things you'll be noticing. The large swimming pool exploit has been fixed. You can now place a small box under the mixing table. And there's now a smoother horse riding motion effect, especially when you're traveling over rough terrain. This has been a summary of all the significant changes coming into Rust this month. I'm Putty, and thanks for watching. If you want to know more about this update or any other update, subscribe to the channel or head on over to Rustified.com, and don't forget to check us out on the Rustified official servers.